Hey, what's up, guys? Thank y'all for tuning in to another one of my videos. In this video, I'll be giving my first impressions on the Altra Lone Peak 7 trail running shoes. I've never used trail runners before. I've only used hiking boots, which I have the Columbia hiking boot, which is like, I think it's under 2 pounds. It's pretty nice. It's a mid-cut boot. And then I think I used a pair of Columbias one day that were pretty nice, mid-cut shoes. So I've used the hiking boots, I've used the hiking shoe, but I've never used a trail runner. Now, I used this shoe that I bought. It was a barefoot hiking water shoe. Here's a picture of it. I can't remember the name of it right now. I used it on the Sipsy for a while, most of that trip. And honestly, my feet feel fine. My ankles did twist, so I really didn't need that ankle support. And it was like I could feel the ground more naturally. I decided to get something lightweight as well because I'll be doing the Alabama Triple Crown, so that kind of locked it in for me. But I mean, I tried the shoe on first thing and I knew that that was it. That was the shoe I was looking for. And I mean, they're the latest and greatest, so maybe they will do pretty good for like backpacking wise instead of just like trail running. But anyway, without further ado, I'm gonna talk some more in this video. So yeah, I'll see y'all out there. What is up, fellas? We are here at the Yokanookany today, and today on this video I'll be doing first impressions on the Altra Lone Peak 7s. So I was a little adamant on getting trail runners, but I kind of thought back on that time I used those water shoes at the Sipsy. They seem fine, so I'm sure these will do great as well. I'm going to kind of give my first impressions on how they are on the trail. Hope y'all enjoy. And yeah, I brought a whole group today. I brought more people into the cult of hiking. Yep, except Tupine. Tupine's been here since the beginning. But we got about 8 miles today to do. Not too much. We'll get it done in like 4 to 5 hours. Hopefully not too muddy. Oof. Anyway, we'll see y'all out there. But look at that view.
Look at it.
Look at it.
What happened to your glasses?
I stepped on them. Well, so far it's been very muddy and slippery, and I've been doing well on it. My shoes are very stable. It's like I can feel the ground, so that's good. It's like a natural feel. So I'm moving pretty good in them. I'm trying to jog them a little bit.
Oh, is this?
Yes.
Which one?
Oh yeah.
That's funny.
I got a little bit of this. That's hard.
Fucking murk.
You know what it is probably?
What?
Somebody's deer processing them and then they're throwing the carcass out here.
Nah man, they got murdered and they got murdered. We need to figure out what's going on.
All right, we're about 3 miles in right now, and so far these shoes are fucking badass. Feels like I don't have any shoes on at all. It's very cushiony. It's pretty durable and stable. Moving pretty good in them right now. Eating some dogs. Not literally. No. Not dogs.
So far it's going fine. I accidentally spilt water in the stove, but it's still running fine, so 10 out of 10. Dudes, they're doing spectacular. They feel amazing. My feet feel free. So we got about 4.5 or 5.5 miles left. So after this, we're gonna keep on trucking. I'll see you back out there. Hello guys, I have a tragic update. 3 hot dogs, because I tried to get them with the knife and it tipped over. So they're just in there. Oh well, I have extra. Everybody else is eating, haven't eaten yet.
Rest, dude.
Don't worry about it, I'm already eating.
Huh?
I'm already eating, you're good.
Yeah, everybody else is eating, that's all that matters. Well, another tragedy update. I ran out of fuel.
On both canisters,
so I'm hoping if I just let it sit there for an hour, it'll
cook.
But we'll see. I think they're okay. I think they're pre-cooked anyway.
Gonna have to raw dog it.
Just raw dog it, fuck it. Alright, well, we're finished with lunch and we're getting back on the trail. So good news, I was able to eat my hot dogs. That's good. But bad news, it took me a while. It's now 3 o'clock. We have 5 miles left, I think. So, it's gonna be a good push, but we got it. I'm definitely getting in with these shoes. They're fucking badass, so we'll see if these chumps are ready for it. All right, so a little update on my shoes. Pretty wet out here, so I've been getting a little wet, you know, water getting in them, but I mean, I just feel it for like a few seconds and it'll like dry out pretty quick. But I got my darn tough wool socks on, so that's helping too. And so far, oh, loving these shoes. Every time my feet slide, I got good grip to get myself back. So loving them so far as just using them for backpacking. Anyway, I think we're getting closer. We're probably about 4 miles away. Gonna keep on trucking. I don't know, but that's good firewood. One of y'all want to tote them?
Let me just get my rope.
There's no way that tree's native to here.
You just sit right here on top of the pad.
Is that like a dinosaur tree?
Hey, Brandon, watch out. This is a carbon dioxide pipeline.
Oh, let's just... We already bust out these miles?
Yep.
Woo woo! Fucking winners. Winner, winner, chicken dinner, David. Okay. You ran that whole way?
Yeah, the whole way. Just to warm up.
Oh yeah, we got 20 more miles. Actually, down that trail right there.
Yeah, let's go. I'm gonna walk back to get the car and then come right back.
Alright, Brent. Alright, we did 8.5 miles and we are all crammed in the car.
Sardines.
Okay, so my first impressions on these shoes. I love them, they're fucking great. I was kind of worried with it being, you know, kind of a
very low cut, that would have been a problem with my ankles, but I didn't have any type of rolling problems. I was trudging through the trail, and like I would step on stumps, and I guess that since I have that natural feel, I'm able to kind of like move into it to where it just doesn't slip. So stability is really good. It's got good grip because I was running through the mud, and you know, I didn't really slip. Like, my feet would slip, but I was able to catch myself pretty well. So no problem there. Traction, pretty damn good. Going uphill, pretty damn good too, with it being slippery. Comfortability, it's pretty comfortable. I think my foot just needs to adjust to how the shoe is because it doesn't have that much cushion, so I'm getting more, I'm feeling more of the ground than I normally would in a boot. But that's no issue there. I'm sure my foot will grow accustomed to it, so comfortability, I like it. Stupid lightweight, I mean, it's so light, I mean, I'm moving pretty dang fast. But my favorite part is the foot box. Foot box is so wide that it makes your feet just kind of, you know, spread out, so when you're stepping, it's just nice feeling. Because I had a problem with that with my boot, and that's the reason why I switched from this boot and wanted to try out the Trail Runner, especially the Ultras, because they're known for their wide foot box. But my feet felt fine. Now, waterproof wise, you know, I'd step in a little puddle here and there. Water would get in the shoe and onto my sock, but I mean, they'd dry off in like a minute. So also keep in mind, I did not get the waterproof version because I read an article that another layer would kind of make it stay wet longer. So I guess it would make more sense to not get a waterproof shoe because it's going to get wet either way. So yeah, all in all, my first impressions, I love it. But we're going to do a true test to this. This next trip on the Sipsy, we'll be doing 18, 20 miles. So yeah, I'll be doing that rough terrain and let y'all know for sure. So thank you for watching the video. I'll see you in the next adventure, which will be the Sipsy. Also, be sure to subscribe because I'm trying to get to 100 subscribers by the end of the year. So that'd be awesome. That's my goal. I think it's a pretty good goal. So got a lot of good goals this year. So I might go into a video on that. But anyway, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.
How is it? It's like a chode. How could it only be that tall?
A chode?
It's wrecking still, though.
It's a big tree.